you know, like I said, the soft, it's the soft and the hard. It can't be all soft or it's not combat skill. It can't be all hard because you're never going to have the sensitivity to find your openings. You know, it's finding the opening, and then once it's open, finding it. So you have to have the yin and yang. You have to have the soft and the hard, right? In other words, when I want to find, you know, for example, a 2-on-1, you know, or an arm drag, it's coming from the sensitivity, right? It's coming from, right? So I have this. I have this. Just by itself, too, right? I was talking about this, which is the tricep pull, right? Pull across. Last week, you know, we were talking about you have pin, right? You have lift. You have pull across. Right? And then, yeah, you have to pull down. But, it's three-dimensional. In other words, it's in this way, it's out this way, right? It's down this way, and it's up this way. The reason that it doesn't go this way is that would be like kind of opening up and then you get, exactly. Whereas, in other words, when I do this, it's hard for you to hit me because, so, this isn't the same thing. In other words, right now, I'm probably not going to get punched because I have two hands on, you know, one hand on each hand. Even for the moment I do this, you know, if he tries to disconnect too much to hit, yeah, you're going to be like, we're either going to both start hitting or he's going to give me an opportunity. At that moment that he pulls back, for example, that gives me an opportunity to come in, right? Or shoot if I went low. That level change. So remember I talked about that level change being very important as an opening last week. So again, in here you see, right? You two, both call 2-on-1s. By itself, you have this lift. Right? And you have this, which is the pin jump, which is a very long thing. You have the bai choy coming around, right? Which was today, right? Right? And I have the arm drag, which, you know, gives me an opportunity to take it back from here also. Boom, right? It all works. So again, you know, we were like here fighting. Maybe he throws a couple of punches, whatever they are, boom, seeing them getting real there. And there's going to be that second doing this, right? Until I do something. Now we're in something different. Thank you, Frank, for proving my point, right? So we just went through three ranges. You see it, right? Train range. Mm-hmm. Okay, now this kind of push hands thing. Right? Sometimes it takes longer than others. Right? Now you got your clinching range. So you see why the sensitivity is important, right? If you're just bullying it, if you're just going in like, you're going to miss that. That second was okay. So again, go back and look. You have pull down. You have pull across. You have pin in. You have lift. You have arm drag. You have 2-on-1. Right? I was talking about suck south, which is when you do this. Like, notice if I get you here. And again, what is this? Spiral, right? That was angle here. You feel how that's different than here we're kind of playing, you know, hand puts, you know, playing handsies, right? When I get a chance to do that. You see the difference? And then here. That's my suck sound, right? So in other words, I go here. See for a second. That's all it took. And then I pull my hips in. Right. And that's this. Talk about all the time. Next thing is when we're in here is, you know, controlling the forearm. So you don't want to leave me here, right? It's here, for example. So you want to do the same thing. But how do you do it without making it, right? Pummel from the top, right? Or, like, do it here. You did this. That's okay sometimes. I like to pummel from the bottom. Why? Because, you know, this works okay, right? But a lot of times you're going to hit the cowlage of the shoulder, right? Whereas if I'm here and I'm coming underneath, it's hard for you to count me, right? And you see that space moves, right? So in other words, from here, if I do this, yeah, sometimes it works. But a lot of times he's going to use cowlage of the shoulder, right? I'm sure you heard cow in Tai Chi, right? It's a big thing, right? The shoulder. So I tend to come from the bottom. Oh, yeah, the steering wheel, right? Remember that? Just like a big bus steering wheel. Get in here. And you also have your steering wheel with the five runs, right? Third one was, I think, loaded into more runs. Right? And then here, this also sets up. So, you have when you're on the outside, you have when you're on the inside. You have here, coming this way, coming this way, and you have in here where we're pummeling in. Don't do two at once. If you do two at once, if you do two at once, right? Come on, do one more time. Right? I get you here, you do two at once. So, you do it one at a time. You do it one at a time. Okay, you got this. Just this magic. Yeah. That's it, that's exactly what you want. Pick it up. Right? Come in there, yeah. All right. Or, yeah. Get two in. Sandwich. Now you see why I do it one at a time? Do you see what I just did there? Right? I went one. So when he's thinking about this, he's not thinking about this. Or I do one. And when he's thinking about this, he's not thinking about this. You know? So I put one, one, two. You see why when you do one at a time, it's easier than doing two? You do two, you get the whole game up. You know? See, I get the whole game up. You see it, right? You feel it. As soon as I do that, no, I want to go here, and when you're responding to the other one, you feel it, right? Now we're 50-50. So I go here.